Okay, we're going to learn today how to divide polynomials. We learned how to use the box in a couple of my other videos. We learned how to use it to multiply polynomials. Now we're going to learn how to divide polynomials with it. So we're going to start off. This is the problem we did in a previous video. We multiplied these two together, x plus 5 times x minus 3. And we're going to first multiply these two together. And I'm going to go through this fairly quickly because there's another video that I have that gives you the details. So if you want to learn the details behind this, you can look at that video. But basically, you make a box and you list one of the factors up here, x plus 5, and you have x and minus 3. So here's the one binomial here, and then here's the x minus 3 binomial here. And you treat this as an area problem. And you say, well, length times width, that tells you what the area is inside, right? So I have this box here. And I make a column for my x and a column for my 5, and then I make a row here for my x's and a row for my negative 3, and I just multiply this side, binomial with this binomial. I go x times x, and I get x squared, and then I get x times 5, and I get 5x, and then I get 5 times minus 3, and you get negative 15. Right? And then I do negative 3 times x, and I get negative 3x. Right? So there's all my boxes are filled in. Now, here's what's interesting. You usually have this term here, diagonally, is going to be x squared, all my x squared terms, and then I have 5x minus 3x, and that comes out to 2x. So I have 2x, and I have this x squared term. And then I have, in this box here, negative 15. So I just add up these boxes that are inside. I just add up all these terms inside here. And typically, usually, not necessarily always, but usually your diagonal terms are usually common. Here I have my x terms, x squared terms, and my constant. And there's my answer there. Okay, so we got the answer. And x squared plus 2x minus 5. Now we're going to do the same problem. We're going to use the box, but we're going to divide. We're going to do the opposite now. We know the answer to this is going to be x minus 3, because we just did the multiplication problem, but we're going to assume that we don't know the answer, and we're going to use the box. So we're going to make our little box here. Right? And we make our box, and then we know that one of the factors there is x plus 5. So we're going to write that along the side there, x and the 5 there, right? So we've got x plus 5, and now we want to know, we know this is going to be x plus 5, so we're going to put our little row here, right? So we got one row for the x's and one row for the 5's, and then we got to figure out what goes across the top here. Is it going to be a binomial? Is it going to be a trinomial? What's it going to be? So to figure that out, we look at the first term of the trinomial here on the numerator, and the first term of the binomial, and we end up with x squared divided by x, right? And what do we get? Oh, that's going to be x, right? Now, really key thing to point out here is it doesn't matter whether this term is negative or positive. It doesn't matter whether the coefficient, this could be negative 2x squared, this could be positive 5x. We're not really so much interested in the coefficient or in the sign of that first term. What we're interested in is what power the variable is going to be. In this case, x squared divided by x is going to be x, and there's an unwritten one there, right? X to the first power, right? So we know this first column is going to be an x variable. And we know since the first column is going to be an x to the first power, that the second column is going to be a constant. So we're going to divide this into two, and here's going to be a constant. We'll just put a little dot there for right now because we know we're going to put an answer there for a constant. And then right here is going to be our x term. It's going to be, I'll put another dot there. So we have an x to the first power and a constant. You know, just like we have an x to the first power and a constant here, and we're going to have an x squared and then an x and a negative 15. So we're going in descending order. So we're doing the same thing here, x to the first power and then a constant. So now we just got to figure out what these two terms are going to be. Well, we remember from the multiplication problem that if you take this first box, it's going to be equal to what? It's going to be equal to x squared, right? It's going to be equal to the first term of the numerator. And these two boxes diagonally, what are these going to be? Oh, those are going to add up to 2x. And then this third term here, oh, what's that going to be? negative 15. So this is going to be equal to negative 15. And this one's, these two are going to be equal to 2x, and this one here is going to be equal to x squared. So now we just got to figure out what goes up here. Well, we know this first box is going to be the easiest one to figure out is x squared. This one is only one box. We know it's x squared. So we got to figure out, okay, x times what gives us x squared? Oh, x. X times x is x squared, right? Now we've got, let's see, x times x is x squared. Now let's see, what else can we do here? Well, we know 5 times x is going to be 5x, right? So we know that box. Oh, but this has to add up to 2x, right? This has to add up to 2x. Well, if this is 2x, that's 5x. What does this have to be? Well, this has to be minus 3x, right? Because 5x minus 3x equals 2x. So we have that. What goes here? Oh, well, this is a negative 15. So 5 times, negative 3, right? 5 times negative 3, that equals negative 15. So now we have, there we go, we have x minus 3 and x plus 5. So our answer here is going to be x minus 3 times x plus 5. Those are the two factors, right? And there's our answer, x minus 3. Okay, so we're going to do one more problem. This one's going to be a little bit more different. It's going to have a remainder. The first problem we did didn't have a remainder, so it's a little easier to figure out. This one's got a remainder, a little bit more complex, but not too much more. So we do the same thing. We make a box, and we'll make this one a little bit, give a little space here. So we've got x squared plus 6x plus 10 divided by x plus 3, and we say, okay, we're going to have one factor, which is x plus 3. X gets a row here, and the 3 gets a row. And then, okay, what goes in the top here? Is it going to be a binomial or is it going to be a trinomial? Well, how do we figure that out? We look at the first term of the numerator, and that's going to be x squared. Then we look at the first term of the denominator, and that's going to be an x. And so the power of our first term is going to be x, right? Again, it doesn't matter whether this is 5x squared and this is negative 2x. The key that we're looking at is we want to know what power the variable is going to have. And in this case, it's going to be x to the first power. So we know this first column is going to, we know it's going to be two columns. And one column is going to have our x variable. Let's put a dot there for right now. And then this one's going to be our constant because it's always going in descending order. Squared, x's, constants, x, constant. So if this is an x, this has to be a constant, right? So now we say, okay, what goes in these boxes? Well, we know that the first column is going to be, the first box here, sorry, is going to be equal to x squared. These two diagonally are going to add up to 6x. And then this last one is going to equal to 10. So now we go, okay, let's fill in the first one. We know this is x squared. X times what gives me x squared? Well, x times x. X times x gives me x squared. And then we go, okay, well, that's an x, right? 3 times x is going to be 3x. Oh, but this has to equal what? This has to equal 6x. 3x, well, if this has to equal 6x, 3x plus 3x, there you go, 3x and 3x make 6x. Okay, well, if this is 3x, what goes up here? Let's see, x times what will give me 3x? Oh, x times 3. So there you go, x times 3 is 3x. Oh, and 3 times 3 is 9. Oh, wait a minute, 9 is not 10. And that last box is supposed to be 9. So what's our answer going to be? It's going to be x plus 3 is going to be our answer. Oh, but with a remainder, right? 10 minus 9 is 1. So we have x plus 3 plus 1 over x plus 3. Yeah, so there's our answer. We have the same factor, x plus 3 times x plus 3, but we have a remainder of 1 because 10 minus 9 is 1, and we have 1 over x plus 3. So there you have it. We'll try one more now. So we got 2x squared minus 5x minus 12 over x minus 4, and we're going to make our box. And we know one of the factors is what? Oh, it's going to be x minus 4, right? And of course, we're going to have one row here for x's and one row here for negative 4. Now we've got to figure out what goes in the top. Is it going to be a binomial? Is it going to be a trinomial? So what do? We look to the lead term of the numerator, and that in this case is going to be 2x squared. And then we looked at the lead term of the denominator, and that's going to be an x. Okay, so again, we don't really need to concern ourselves with this 2. We really don't need to look at that. We're concerned with what's x squared divided by x. Oh, that's going to be x. That means the first column, that means it's going to be, it's going to have an x term in it, x to the first power. So we're going to have an x to the first power here where this dot's at, and then we're going to have another one, we're going to have a constant there, right? Because this is always in descending order. So this is going to be two columns. This is going to be our x term, this is going to be our constant. Now we got to figure out, let's see, oh, that's right, we know that this box here is going to be what? Equal to 2x squared. And we know that these two boxes here are going to be equal to negative 5x. And we know that this box is going to be equal to what? Oh, it's going to be equal to negative 12x. So we say, okay, we're going to have x. Oh, this is going to be 2x squared, right? X times what? It's going to be 2x squared. Oh, that's going to be times 2x, right? X times 2x is 2x squared. Now we got to look and see what else. Okay, so we've got, if that's 2x, then 2x times negative 4 is what? Negative 8x. Negative 4 times 2x is negative 8x. And then what do we do? Okay, now we've got, oh, but if this is negative 5x, then this has to be what? Oh, negative 8x plus what will give me negative 5x? Oh, positive 3x, right? So there's our 3x. That would mean that x times what gives me 3x? Well, this has to be a positive 3, right? And then if that's 3, 3 times negative 4 is negative 12, and sure enough, negative 12 is equal to negative 12 there. So there's our answer there. We've got, what is our answer going to be? 2x plus 3. There you have it. So check this out. Try some of these problems at home. Let us know your thoughts. Hopefully it works out well for you. If you don't like it, maybe you learned something in the process. Good luck to you.